everyone, welcome to Novel Chit Chat. So here are the few takeaways from Who Will Cry When You Die by Robin Sharma. In this book, the author has given around 101 life lessons. And today we'll be telling you best out of these, so let's get started. So Who Will Cry When You Die is not about this question. It's more about the meaning and purpose of life. It's about live your life in such a way that when you die, the world cries while you rejoice. One of the lessons that I have learned in my own life is that if you don't act on life, life has a habit of acting on you. The days slips into weeks, the weeks slip into months, and the months slip into years. Pretty soon it's all over and you are left with nothing more than a heart filled with regret over a half-lived life. So now the question arouses that how can you do this? So here you go. Number 1. Find your calling. I believe we all have special talents that are just waiting to be engaged in a worthy pursuit. Finding your calling doesn't mean you must leave the job you are currently doing or something like that. It simply means you need to bring more of yourself into your work and focus on things you do best. It means you have to stop waiting for others, people to make the change you desire. As Mahatma Gandhiji said, be the change that you wish to see most in your world. And once you do it, your life will be changed. Number 2. Every day be kind to a stranger. Everyone who enters your life has a lesson to teach and a story to tell. In my mind, if you make even one person smile during your day or brighten the mood of even one stranger, your day has been worthwhile one. In short, kindness is the rent that we must pay for the space we occupy on this planet. So let's be kinder to one another. Number 3. Practice tough love. Tough love here means self-discipline, which is the important part for a great life ahead. Tough love because getting tough with yourself is actually a very loving gesture. Number 4. Keep a journal. Now here, maintaining a journal is one of the best personal growth initiatives you will ever take. Writing down your daily experiences along with the lessons you have drawn from them will make you more wiser with each passing day. You will develop self-awareness and make less mistakes. It will give you a regular one-to-one conversation with yourself. Do remember, if your life is worth thinking about, it is worth writing about. So do write it. Number 5. Develop an honest philosophy. We live in a world of broken promises. We live in a time when people treat their words lightly. We tell a friend we will call her next week for lunch, knowing we do not have time to do so. We promise ourselves this will be the best year. We will get back to the shape, simplify our lives and have more fun without any real intention of making the deep life changes necessary to achieve these goals. Saying things we don't actually mean become a habit when we practice it for so long. So make honest commitments and do not trick yourself by making false statements. Be a person of your word rather than being all talk and no action. Number 6. Honor your past means you should always not worry about your past, just think about your future. Think about all those things that you wish never happened to you is actually blocking all the things you want to happen from entering into your life. Instead of thinking about problems, you should learn from your past experiences to rise into a whole new level of awareness. And understand that if you have failed more than others, then there is a very good chance that you are living more completely than others. Begin to see your troubles as blessings and then turn your wounds into wisdom. Number 7. Start your day well. The way you start your day matters a lot. The first 30 minutes after you wake up is the most precious one and have a profound influence on the quality of every minute that follows. It's like own your morning and elevate your life. So use this 30 minutes very effectively, maybe 15 minutes as meditation and the other 15 about thinking about your goals or reading any book or whatever that suits you best. So good luck, start your day well and you will never be the same. Number 8. Talk to yourself. Well, this is the most amazing one and I personally do this too. Talking to yourself in front of mirror regarding your problems or repeating affirmations for a good cause makes you feel better and confident. Talk to yourself regarding those tough days when no one was there for you and still you nailed it. Be your own best friend and love yourself every day. Number 9. Laugh more. On an average, 4-year-old laughs 300 times a day, while the average adult laughs around 15 times a day. With all the obligations, stresses and activities that fill our days, we have forgotten to laugh. Daily laughs has been shown to elevate our moods, promote creativity and give us more energy. Laughter therapy has ever been used to cure illnesses and heal those with serious ailments. So watch more comedy shows or other shows that makes you laugh or make you happy inside out. Number 10. Take more risks. I can bet you on this that on your deathbed, it will not be all the risks that you took that you will regret the most. Rather, what will fill your heart with greatest regrets will be those risks and opportunities that you didn't take. Remember, on the other side of fear lies freedom. The more risks you take, the more reward you will receive. So live your life to the fullest, start taking more risks and do the things you fear. Number 11. Master your time. Time is the most important thing in our lives. We often procrastinate and put the achievement of our dreams on hold, which is wrong. Commit yourself to managing your time more effectively. Use these 24 hours a day as the best you can do. Develop a sense of urgency and awareness about how important your time really is. Number 12. Go on a news fast. In our society, people choose to watch criminal trial of a celebrity rather than the biography of a truly great human being. Reading negative news leaves very bad effect on us. The best you can do in this is to make sure not to read even one negative story in the newspaper or TV for at least 1 week. By doing this, you will notice that you will not really miss out much of the information as you will still hear about those from people around you or the social media. Next thing you will notice that you feel much more peaceful by doing this. So do try this in order to live peacefully. Also, be selective in the news you expose your mind to. Number 13. Find 3 great friends. Cultivating great friendships is one of the surest ways to find more happiness and joys in your life. Having a friend with good heart and positive energy is such a blessing. So never feel shy in raising the hand for friendships. Every human being has a deep need for affection and most people will be delighted that you took the initiative. And if they do not respond, so what? Rather than viewing it as rejection, see it as their loss and move ahead. Number 14. Be more than your moods. It means learn to work even when you are not in mood to do the same. Moods are not beyond control. You are the creator of your moods and you can change it in fraction of seconds if you choose to do so. Number 15, last but not the least, live full so you can die happy. Most people around us don't discover what life is all about until just before they die. While we all are young, we spend our days striving and keeping up with the social expectations. We are busy chasing big pleasures that we miss out on the little ones, like dancing on a rainy day or a movie date with our family and so on. Here it says, learn to appreciate little things and enjoy your life as it is. Do not wait until you are on your deathbed to realize the meaning of your life. Damn, just start living it at the very present moment. So this was all about today's video and these all are the takeaways that I loved. So this book is full of amazing lessons. So do read it any day for the great motivation. Thank you for watching this video. Do subscribe this channel for more amazing updates if you haven't yet. And for more good content, do visit our website Novel Chit Chat, link in the description below. Thank you.